Welcome to the class on game theory at the University of Mannheim in the autumn term 2020. We have seen the definition of games in normal form. We have seen the notions Maximin strategy, dominant strategy, and Nash equilibrium. And we have seen already two examples. One, the most famous one, is the prisoner's dilemma. And the other one is a battle of the sexes, and there we had three different variants. In this video, I will discuss two other examples, the lion-lamb example, and there will also be three variants, and afterwards the game scissors, stone, paper, which everybody knows from childhood. So the lion-lamb example gives us a frame for several related examples. We have again two players. So the player set is again the numbers 1 and 2, and each player has two strategies, which are here called lion and lamb. And you will see why they are called like this. So lion is usually aggressive and lamb is usually peaceful. So, and furthermore, some item with value V, because 0 is given. And if both players are lions, then they will fight for this item. And there will be a loss due to the fight, loss D bigger 0, or bigger equal 0. And each gets then V minus D half. If both are lambs, the fact that they don't fight might give a gain W bigger 0, or bigger equal 0. And then each gets V plus W half. But if one is a lion and the other a lamb, the lion gets all of V and the lamb gets 0. And there is no additional loss or gain. So in this general setting, the utility values are given in this following table. Lion, lion, each gets V minus D half. Lamb, lamb, each gets V plus W half. Lion, lamb, V 0. Lamb, lion, 0, V. Now, we will specialize this to concrete numbers and have some additional interpretation for these numbers. The special arms race, especially the case arms race, is a case where V is high, but D is also quite high and W is 0. And if you plug in these numbers, we get the table that you see below. Lion, lion, each gets 1. Lamb, lamb, each gets 2. Lion, lamb, 4, 0. Lamb, lion, 0, 4. So if one is a lion and the other is a lamb, then the lion gets definitely by far the most. And if both are lambs, each gets quite something, each gets 2, which is better than if both are lions. But in the case lion-lamb, of course, the lamb is the poor guy and gets 0. So here one sees immediately that the preference orders are the same as in the example 211, the prisoner's dilemma. And yeah, also the numbers are slightly different, but altogether this is almost the same as that example. Here we have so lion stands now for, is equivalent to defect, and lamb is equivalent to cooperate. If both cooperate, they get 2-2. If both alliance and defect, they get 1-1. But if one defects and the other cooperates, then the one who cooperates gets 0 and the one who defects gets 4, so that's the best. So just in the prisoner's dilemma case here, lion is a dominant strategy for both players. And lion lion gives the only Nash equilibrium, and I think lion is also for each player the only Maximin strategy. If one plays lion, he can expect that the other plays also lion, because one is smaller than 4 in the pessimistic case. If one plays lamb, he can expect the other's lion, so he gets 0. Therefore, lion is better than lamb in the pessimistic case. But lion is better anyway, because it's a dominant strategy. And lion lion is the only Nash equilibrium. So this is essentially the prisoner's dilemma with slightly different numbers and a different frame, a different interpretation. Next case, the chicken game. It's also a rather tough game. Here the loss is really high. D is equal to 4 and the win is 0. So one possible interpretation: we have a narrow road in the countryside and two cars are approaching from opposite directions. And one has to go to the side and leave the road, and it's not so good for his car, but it's not so bad. And the lamb strategy is to go to the side, and the lion strategy is to stay in the middle and to expect the other to go to the side. So if both stay in the middle, there's a crash and the cars are broken and the people are injured, and then they have a big damage. So lion, lion gives the value minus one, minus one. If both are lambs, both shun and they can manage to go along, and both cars get some scratches, but it's fine. Both get 1-1. If one is lion, the other is lamb, then the lion stays straight and can go fast along, and he gets the utility value 2. And the lamb has to shun, but there's no accident, so he just gets the value 0. So here, this is quite close to the variants 1 and 2 in the Battle of the Sexes, where lion for the woman is the cinema, lion for the man is soccer, lamb for the woman is soccer, and lamb for the man is cinema. So lamb means to give in, for the woman it's to go to soccer, for the man it's to go to cinema. Lion is to stick to the better place, for the woman it's cinema, for the man it's soccer. So in this slices, the preference orders agree with the preference orders of this variants 1 and 2 in the Battle of the Sexes. Therefore, and because of this remark 295, the dominant strategies and the Nash equilibria are again the same. So here, dominant strategies don't exist. Of course, we can see this also directly. If the other plays lion, lion is worse than lamb. If the other plays lamb, lion is better than lamb. So we don't have a dominant strategy for each player. Nash equilibria, again, like in variants 1 and 2, it's lion lamb and lamb lion. So if one gives in and the other holds its position, that is a Nash equilibrium. But here we have again two Nash equilibria, so we have complete symmetry. So it's hard to guess which Nash equilibrium will be chosen or should be chosen. So in Maximin strategies here, they are in both cases a lamb. So now the pessimistic point of view, if player one expects always to player two to make the bad choice, and the bad choice is always the lion position. If player one plays lion, then player two lion means minus one for player one. And if player one plays lamb, player two playing lion means zero for player one. So the infima are minus one and zero. And here, of course, lamb is better. One gets just zero, not minus one. And the same for player two. So here, each has one maximin strategy, and that's the strategy to give in, and it's a lamb strategy. So there's a third case, which is somehow probably the oldest of these cases. It goes back to Rousseau. Rousseau had written a parable of a deer hunt. Jean-Jacques Rousseau had a treatise on the origin of inequality in French, and that contained a parable about the dichotomy between individual aims and joint actions. So the distance or difference between the individual aims and that what the joint actions require. So, and he had some old-fashioned frame, some interpretation. So here there are two hunters, and they are in a forest, and there is some woods, and they have encircled a deer and two rabbits. So a deer is a big animal, and they really would like to get the deer, but the rabbits are also not worthless. And the lion strategy is egoistic. It means to bend forward, and then the deer jumps free over oneself. The person who bends then leaves place for the deer to go free. But the person who bends forwards can grab at least one rabbit. If the other hunter also bends forward, he gets one rabbit. And if the other hunter stays straight, he gets even both rabbits. So in the lamb strategy is to stay straight. If oneself stays straight and the other two, then together one can get the deer, but the rabbits go for free. But if oneself stays straight and the other bends forward, one gets nothing. One doesn't catch the rabbits and the deer goes free too. So, and here the values are, the item is worth 4 units, and the loss is 0, and the gain is 6. So the deer is worth a lot. Working together gives a big gain. So here the numbers are as you see. Lion lion means 2-2, lamb lamb means 5-5. And lion lamb means the lion gets 2 rabbits, so 4 units, and the other one gets 0. So lamb lion is 0-4 and lion lamb is 4-0. So and this is now a different game from before. The different numbers give us a different game. And now let's discuss now maximum strategies, dominant strategies, and Nash equilibria. So maximum strategies. Player one expects to have bad luck with player two. So if player one plays lion, he might grab 2 rabbits or 1 rabbit. So if the other plays lion two, he gets only 1 rabbit, so value 2. So that's the worst case if one save is lion. If one save plays the role of a lamb, one save stays straight. If the other works with one save, one gets 5, which is very good. But if the other again plays lion, one gets nothing, 0. So in this case, the minimum is 0. And the pessimistic player, he looks at the infima, the minima. So in the lion case, it's 2. In the lamb case, it's 0. So the only maximum strategy is to play lion. So dominant strategy again doesn't exist. If the other plays lion, one should also play lion. That's then better than lamb. If the other plays lamb, here one should also play lamb. The cooperation is worth a lot, the whole deer. So then one should also play lamb. So there is no dominant strategy for player one. And the same for player two. Also player two does not have a dominant strategy. So equilibria, we have 2 equilibria here, namely lion lion and lamb lamb. So these are both equilibria. If the other plays lion, it's good for one safe to play lion. So one should stick to this equilibrium. Therefore, this is a symmetric Nash equilibrium. And if the other plays lamb, one should also stick to being lamb, because then one gets 5 units, half the deer. And if one plays lion, one gets the 2 rabbits, which is just 4 units. So if the other plays lamb, one safe should also stay and stick to the role of a lamb. Therefore, the pair lion-lion, as well as the pair lamb-lamb, they are both Nash equilibria. So here we see a situation where we have 2 Nash equilibria with different utility values for both players. One has a better utility values than the other one. I think this example, in that sense, this example is new. Before we had also in the Battle of the Sexes several Nash equilibria, but the values were also different for each player. But the sum of the values was the same. So we have here had the one joint frame, this lion lamb frame with these numbers V, W, and D, and we see that different values for V, D, and W give us completely different interpretations and different behaviors of these games. So and finally in this section I come to another rather famous game, which you all probably know from early childhood. It's again a two-person game, and it is called scissors, stone, paper. So if small children have to make a choice and make a decision who wins something, who gets something, this is a favorite way to reach this choice. So two children form simultaneously with one hand a pair of scissors or a stone or a piece of paper. And the rule says that the pair of scissors cuts the paper. So if one makes the pair of scissors and the other the paper, the first one wins. Then the paper wraps the stone, so paper wins against stone. And the stone blunts the pair of scissors. So it destroys this pair of scissors. So the stone wins against the scissors. So here's a nice thing that for each pair of figures that one can make with the hand, one is winning and the other is losing. And there is no dominant strategy, but we have somehow a circle of strategies. So the scissor, then they are even, there is no win and loss. But scissor, stone, The second wins, scissors, paper, the first wins. Stone, stone, nothing. Stone, scissors, first wins. Stone, paper, second wins. Paper, paper, nothing. Paper, scissors, second wins. Paper, stone, first wins. So here we have obviously no dominant strategies for a player one and two. Whatever you choose, the other can make a choice such that you lose. So that you don't have a dominant strategy. Also, here we have no Nash equilibria. If the other makes a choice, of course, you have a best answer to the other person's choice. But then the other will change his opinion. So we don't have Nash equilibria. If we had a Nash equilibrium, that would be a pair of strategies such that both are happy with this pair of strategies if the other sticks to his choice. But here, whatever the other does, you can make a choice such that you win, but then the other will lose. But then he can make another choice such that he wins. And that shows that we can't have Nash equilibria. So there is no stable pair of choices for both players with which both are happy. Maximin strategies, it's easy here. Whatever you do, you might lose. And the value is in minus one. So for every possible strategy, if you have bad luck, the other will win and you will lose and your value will be minus one, so always the same value. That means here all three strategies are Maximin strategies. They are all equally bad or equally good. Nothing is better than the others. So this is in some sense unsatisfactory. We have Maximin strategies, but this really doesn't matter which one. We don't have dominant strategies, we don't have Nash equilibria, so what to do with this game? Especially, we don't have Nash equilibria, that's a bit hurting. But we will come back to this example in chapter 3, in the examples 3-4 and 3-14. In chapter 3, we will consider mixed extensions of finite games. So in this game, scissors, stone, paper is a finite game. We have two players and each has only three strategies. And in chapter 3, we will consider some extension of this to a game where some choices are made with some probability. So then the spaces of strategies are finite dimensional subsets of some real vector space, And it will turn out that in these extensions, the extended game has a Nash equilibrium. This will be quite an interesting point. And this is a special case of a famous result of Nash in the early times. He proved that in all cases, all mixed extensions of finite games have Nash equilibria. And here we have some prominent example. The original game, the finite game, does not have Nash equilibria, but the mixed extension will have some very sensible Nash equilibrium. So this now finishes the section 2.2 about many different examples. And in the next video, I will come to, again, something more conceptual, to the best reply map. But that will not be necessary for the first sheet of exercises. So in order to work on the first sheet of exercises, you should work through the course until this point, but it's not necessary to go on further for the first sheet of exercises. So thank you very much for this video, and goodbye.